than young Jim McBride, who's injured. And the most significant change in goal, the man coming in place of Alan McCulloch, the broken ankle victim, is that man, Jim Brown, 20 years old, signed from Beath Juniors 2 years ago. He's only played once before in the Kilmarnock first team, and that in the Anglo-Scottish Cup against Blackpool. And a couple of changes in the Rangers side. Also, Derek Johnston and John McDonald come back into the side in place of Tom Forsyth and Willie Johnston. And the happiest man, no doubt, the Rangers club captain, Derek Johnston. He's only started one competitive match this season so far at centre-forward against Forfar in the League Cup. Now getting his chance in place of Tom Forsyth in the heart of the Rangers defence. So Kilmarnock in their change strip of red and white stripes to kick off. That's Bobby Street and John Bourke setting the game in motion. Long ball in for Bobby Houston. That gives Peter McCloy an early touch. There's Derek Johnston becoming involved very early on. Tommy McLean going into a midfield position right away now for Rangers. That's McAdam. Now Jardine. John McDonald, the direct replacement for Willie Johnston. He'll no doubt play in a striking role. That's Redford back to Johnston. Some uncertainty there. And John Bourke almost cashing in. That's Bourke again going on to Houston's throw. Just stumbling as he does so. So the Rangers line up immediately, showing Davy Cooper taking up a position on the left, with John McDonald and Colin McAdam joining him up front. McLean, Bett and Redford in midfield. That's McAdam getting the touch. Here's John McDonald. Andy Jardine making a long run from deep. That one no doubt designed to test young Jim Brown in the Kilmarnock goal, but no trouble there from that overstruck cross. Here's little Gordon Crammond, £60,000 from Ayr United last season. By Jim Clark, and that's Jackson content to head that one on to Peter McCloy. Now Redford. That's Bett being forced back. The Kilmarnock midfield players staying very close indeed on the Rangers players to allow them no room at all to build things. There's Alec Miller. Now it's Bett. He's had to go very deep to get possession. Colin Jackson. Kilmarnock marking is very tight. There's John McDonald shrugging off the challenge. Now McLean into space for McAdam. And that's the best possible start for Colin McAdam. Just 2 minutes gone, and he scores his eighth competitive goal of the season. A build-up on the right. John McDonald resisting the challenge from behind from Alan Robertson. Ball came inside to McLean, and McLean showing his great dexterity close to goal. A beautiful pass into the path of McAdam, and poor Jim Brown really had very little chance. Finding Cooper, Stuart McLean challenging. That's Houston winning possession. Back it comes to the Kilmarnock captain, Alan Robertson. And now Brown, who's had a very daunting baptism in Premier League football. Here's little McLean again. John McDonald coming off Robertson. McLean again. Now it's Cooper. Got a chance to run at Stuart McLean. The cross in for McAdam. Yeah, that was excellent control from Colin McAdam. He resisted the temptation to have a header from a narrow angle. And that shot might well have given Rangers their second goal in the space of 5 minutes. A long kick from hand from Brown. The head on from Bourke. That Street, now some space for John Bourke. Chance to attack Alec Miller. A fine cross and excellent goalkeeping by Peter McCloy. Do you have any hopes of a second chance at that one? And John Bourke is the man who's miles offside there as that ball comes back. That one aim for McLean, but asking far too much of little Rangers player. That's McDicken playing it across the back. Stuart McLean. Get it down by Johnston. Now it's Bourke. That's Street in a very intelligent run ahead of Houston. And Redford doing a very good job indeed for Rangers, picking up that run, getting back very quickly. Now it's Jim Clark in space. For Street. A superb goal by John Bourke for Kilmarnock. Just the recovery Kilmarnock wanted. 13 minutes on the clock. And that was the imagination there of Bobby Street. He made a superb run to take that through ball. It wasn't picked up by the Rangers defence. The ball came right across the six-yard box. The Rangers defence couldn't cut it out. And there's John Bourke scoring his first goal of the season for Kilmarnock. So a marvellous opening period here at Rugby Park. Honours even, Kilmarnock 1, Rangers 1. And the crowd very much on their toes. Some excellent football. Here's Alec Miller for Rangers. That's cut off by McLean. Bobby Houston on the run now. Redford trying to get back in terms with him. That's for Bourke. And so close to goal number two, but referee Cuthell indicating handball there. As the cross came over, looked as though Jackson should clear up. Looks like good refereeing by Mr. Cuthill. Derek Johnston could come a long way forward if he wanted here. Here's McLean. Now it's Mike Miller. Now McAdam on the left for the first time. McLean trying to evade Gordon Trammell. He doesn't succeed. That's the ball winning abilities of Jim Bett. Stopping at Kilmarnock move. Here's Gordon Trammell with a throw. He's the Kilmarnock top scorer despite playing in midfield with three goals so far. It's a good challenge by Miller. And fine touch there by Redford. Now it's McAdam forcing his way towards the corner flag. McLean still with him. That's a great cross. And John McDonald steals into the space to give Rangers the lead once again. The burst on the left from Colin McAdam causing the trouble. John McLean never got in terms. An excellent cross with McAdam's weaker foot. And no one picked up that run from John McDonald. Marvellous header, and that gives him his fourth goal of the season. Now Clark fighting hard. The space for Houston. He's very good with the cross balls from here. And a marvellous diving header there. Bobby Street coming in from the left. Again, he was picked up by the Rangers defence. And Peter McCloy did very well indeed to prevent that being Kilmarnock's equaliser. Now here's Johnston, the chance to move into that space ahead. Bent to John, and Rangers finding extra men coming from the back four. Here's McLean. Hands off Derek McDicken. This time the short one to vary things. Spinning out. Another bad effort from Colin Jackson. Certainly willing to have a go with head or foot. When the goals are near, Colin Jackson. And Rangers perhaps sensibly switching Derek Johnston to Mark Bourke for the kickouts. Now it's Street. A deflection from Jardine. So this is just Kilmarnock's second corner kick of the match. Well, we streak to take it. There's Kerry Armstrong trotting up to join the attack. Derek McDickens up too. That's Bourke with the header, a glancing header, which might well have caused the Rangers defence even more trouble. That's Robertson. And Loughlin leaves it for Houston. No free kick to the referee. Now it's McAdam, back to Cooper. Chance for Lily Cooper. Well, that's a controversial decision. An indirect free kick awarded there by referee Cuthill. I don't think there's much doubt at all that that body check by McDicken would have resulted in a penalty kick in many matches or many before many referees. And certainly, I for one am never terribly happy with indirect free kicks inside the box. But still considerable danger for the Kilmarnock defence. They won't want to lose a third goal just before half-time. Back it comes to Redford. Well, penalty kick or no, Ian Redford striking that powerfully into the net. Little ball square from McAdam. And the ball goes sweeter than that from the left foot of Ian Redford. Postage stamp corner, his first goal of the season, and he'll be hard pushed to score a better. Playing in field, but Dickens there, but so is Johnston. And that's a good strong shot there from John Bourke, just wide of the left hand post. Stunning first half performance from Rangers. There's Jim Brown, an unfortunate young goalkeeper for Kilmarnock. He's been beaten by three goals which he had no hope of saving. Let's hope his confidence is in no way shattered for his Premier League career. So let's not be stinting in the praise for Rangers in that first half. It really was a stunning performance, some very high quality football played right throughout the side, and thoroughly justifying that 3-1 lead, and giving food for thought incidentally to Drew Jarvie, who's sitting in the stand below us here, obviously spying for his club Aberdeen, whom Rangers meet on Wednesday night in the second leg of the League Cup tie. The Rangers coming forward right away, and that's spinning into the net. Well, Sandy Jordan, but the most disconsolate figure on the field is that young man, Jimmy Brown. I had hoped that he wouldn't be suffering too much from that first half blitz, but that very direct shot from Sandy Jordan should have caused him no trouble at all. But as you can see, squirming out of his arms to give Rangers the best possible start to the second half, and a 4-1 lead. Davy Cooper. See how far forward Sandy Jordan, number two, has come. Join the Rangers' attack. Here he is now, another shooting chance. And poor Jim Brown seems to be getting nothing but awkward shots. That one dipping and swerving towards him. And perhaps the shade forced it that the Rangers' forwards weren't following up more closely. Here's Bobby Street. Play by Street, now it's Mochlin. And that save looked easy, but it was a tribute to McCloy's positioning. Alistair Mochlin with the effort. It's Bobby Houston. McLean and McAdam still working very hard. It's a bad late tackle. There's no need at all, though, for Colin McAdam to remonstrate, because referee Bob Cuthill will do that job perfectly adequately on his own. A booking then for Stuart McLean. I must say, I have a degree of sympathy with him. It's his first bad tackle, and it seemed to me that he was late rather than malicious. So that's Stuart McLean joining his fullback partner Alan Robertson in the referee's book. And Tommy McLean to take the free kick for Rangers. That's towards Derek Johnston, lets it go. John McDonald! And a very firm, precise shot from John McDonald when that ball was headed clear after McLean's free kick. Jimmy Brown almost certainly unsighted. That sea of both forwards and defenders ahead of him. And that's John McDonald's second goal of the match. So 12 minutes of the second half gone. Kilmarnock 1, Rangers 5. But Kilmarnock coming forward again. Alistair Mochlin and Street find a way past Jardine and get a chance to shoot. Here's Crammond. And just look at Peter McCoy's positioning beyond the 6-yard box to take that one. Great goal kick taken by McCoy. That's McLean sending McDonald away. McAdam's in the middle. Support coming from Cooper. There's McLean. That's Redford gone very cleverly to the outside. McDickens header. This is Redford again. Setting it up for Miller. Now Bett on his left foot. Tim Bett, and look at the delight on his face. That was a shot of staggering power from Bett. Just look at the room he got to set it up. And the stunning power of that left foot shot. And let there be no questions asked of Jimmy Brown on that occasion. No goalkeeper on the land would have saved it. That's Tommy McLean. And the willing running of John McDonald, finding space again for Rangers. Was McAdam, Armstrong matching him, strength for strength. Here's McDicken. The control letting him down a fraction there. Ball cannoning off McAdam, but no ill feeling on the part of these two opponents. So Tommy McLean lining up, an outswinger no doubt, with Derek Johnson coming into the box very late this time. That's towards McAdam. Brown beats it out. Redford. And the save by Jim Clark, surely using his left hand. Yes, a delay on the part of the referee before awarding the penalty kick. But penalty kick it surely was, as you can see, was Jim Clark coming across. And that's handball by Clark, which means a booking in the language of Scottish League rules now, at the discretion of the referee. The yellow card for Jim Clark just adds insult to injury, really. And this time it's Ian Redford. This is the fourth penalty kicker Rangers have had this season. And a successful one at that. Ian Redford's second goal of the match and the season. Humping the ball firmly behind Jimmy Brown. It's Rangers' seventh goal. And Ian Redford becomes the fourth man to take a penalty for Rangers, the third man to be successful. And still Jim Clark, help coming from Ian Gibson, number 12, but that's Johnston stepping in now for Scythe, with four Rangers players up. Support coming from Redford. It goes to Cooper. Willie Johnston. And just losing control fractionally there. Cooper flights it in. John McDonald. John McDonald makes it goal number 8 for Rangers. And to be as charitable as possible, I wonder if Brown was expecting the whistle to go, but a tangle at the edge of the box between Jimmy Clark and Willie Johnston. But that's just on the final whistle now. John McDonald heading that one home. The complete
complete the day of misery for Kilmarnock. And that's the final whistle. Referee Bob Cothill. A quite outstanding performance from Rangers. And a day which, unfortunately, goalkeeper Jim Brown, just 20 years old, making his Premier League debut, will never forget. The day he met Rangers in full cry, and the day that...
scored two.